gentlemen, boys and girls, bonitas, bonitos, muchachos, muchachas. Welcome to the Musical Care Radio Show, where everything's that bring you a song. One big tune, I give you a piece of my platform, and I think you should know us. Hey, yo, tune in the back. I'm a man of many words, I eat you in scrapple. When the boys in tell you, no, it's trouble. I do my own stunts, I don't need no double L. You ain't giving it something. I got a girl for you, but tonight I said, oh, how you? Like a tea in a kettle. Give me breakfast, give me lunch, give me dinner. You know, like going to the Musical Care Radio Show, we all shoot there, yes, yeah. Cloudy, gray Thursday, we give thanks every day. Like, walk on, walk. All the pretty girls from the love with me. All the bad ones up with me. All the real ones know I'm that. Yes, all the real ones know that I am the one. And this is the Musical King Radio Show. In case you don't know, in case you weren't aware, tuned in the back, coming from the man of where they made the legend. ASEM, and he calls this song Office Forecast 1.0. New ASEM music collection available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. More new music on the way. Weather channel coming soon. And if you go on Spotify, you search for ASEM Afro Grooves, you can find this tune together with other bad vibes. I'm near myself and I curate for your listening pleasure. What is going on in the world? It's been an eventful week, an action-packed week, if I could say so. Politics as usual, and in the political world, all conversation is about the 2024 elections. The Republicans against the Democrats, Biden versus Trump, has been what everybody talking about in the news cycle, campaign funds. Even though Joe Biden is behind in the polls when it comes to raising funds for his campaign, it looks like he's miles ahead of Trump amidst all his legal battles and wars. We are talking about Donald Trump and his battle in the race to the 2024 election. They're trying to cripple him through legal means, or should I say, most people think it's unconstitutional how the Democrats are persecuting Trump. Trump's former finance chief was sentenced to 5 months in Rikers for lying to the New York Attorney General's office. Right-wing House Republicans refused to extend a surveillance law after Trump publicly denounced it. Iowa made it a crime for a person to enter the state if they have ever been deported or denied entry into the U.S. The migrant crisis, the border, is the big conversation of concern across the length and breadth of America. What are the stance of the Democrats and Republicans, Trump and Biden, in how they can combat this migrant crisis? Let's talk about all things Israel and Hamas. We are still dialoguing and pleading for a ceasefire for the innocent lives and children in Palestine. An Israeli airstrike killed 3 sons of Ismail Haniyeh, the political leader of Hamas. Israel said they were military operatives. Hamas said it did not have 40 living hostages in Gaza who met the criteria for the first step of an exchange deal. There's been talk of this exchange deal for a while. It always feels like they are close to having a consensus. Then as they take 3 steps backwards, people are dying, lives are on the line, children and women, and Israel and Hamas issues need to be rectified as soon as possible. We're talking about a state visit for the Japanese state visit was also big news among Democrats and Biden this week, where Biden and Japan's Prime Minister Fumio Kishida announced more military and economic collaboration to counter China. Russia and China is always in the mix when it comes to U.S. international affairs with Japan. Kishida, who also promised to give Washington 250 cherry trees, they will replace 140 that are being uprooted to make way for taller seawalls around Jefferson Memorial. The Joe Biden climate deal is also a big conversation. I believe they had talks around that. Joe Biden wore an Oscar de la Renta gown to the state dinner its subtle symbolism was a preview of her role in the presidential campaign. Whatever, let's talk about more cheery and more dairy stuff. The Champions League came back this week. It has been an action-packed week of football and soccer. They lived up to its billing. I mean, I've been watching the game for quite some time now. I haven't seen a Champions League quarterfinal matchup that has lived up to what the games were. The Real Madrid, Man City was my pick. But if you take all of those games out, I mean, the Bayern Munich and Arsenal had great moments. Yesterday, Barcelona and PSG, Kylian Mbappe's quest to leave on a high. It has been finalized that he's leaving this season. His contract is going to end. He's not extending. It will be a fairy tale story worthy of Kylian Mbappe if he's able to win the Champions League. But yesterday, Barcelona, Pedri, a key substitution made by Xavi. Pedri came on and a wonderful, splendid goal by Rafinha made it hard. PSG have to go back to the Montjuïc in Barcelona to see if they can get a win. That game ended 3-2. It's been a wonderful week of football and soccer, and it's not even over yet because the Europa League is also going on today, where Liverpool, giants of English football, European football, relegated to the Europa League, has made it exciting than regular. They are playing against the Italian team Atalanta. Benfica is playing against Olympic Marseille. AC Milan is playing against Roma. That is going to be one for the books. AS Roma and AC Milan, and surprise German Bundesliga impending on the way to become champions, Bayern Leverkusen, under the managerial of Xavi Alonso, former Real Madrid midfielder. They have been the revelation for the season when it comes to European football. They will also be in action with the English side, West Ham. Thank you for tuning into the Musical King radio show. Champions League came this week. Who do you tip to win it all? I think PSG and Barcelona yesterday. Atletico Madrid beat Dortmund as well, 2-1. The away legs are awaiting. But I will want to see a Bayern Munich PSG final. Man City, I mean, of course, they've done it before. Pep Guardiola has won it all. I want to see a different change of guard, a change of honor. It will be exciting to watch Harry Kane in a Champions League final. They have to beat Arsenal at home. I don't think Thomas Tuchel is going to bottle it at the Allianz Arena. I tip a Bayern Munich PSG final. Who do you think is going to win it? Thank you for tuning into the Musical King radio show. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0 new Ascend music collection available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. More music on the way. Coming soon.